bit of context, this is supposed to be a laptop.
Context is key.
Another morning with having to do a Zoom session. How much longer is this going to be? All right, here it goes. I'm going to hit the button. We're starting the class. Peter's in, first as usual. Hey, Peter, good morning. How are you?
Good morning, Mr. Mack. It's so good to see you.
It is great to see you, too.
Day.
It is a good day,
yes.
Hey, Chris. Welcome in.
Hey, good morning, Mr. Mack. Good to see you.
Good to see you, too.
Peter, how about that run yesterday?
Yeah, you know, I started my morning, I was practicing my flute and playing my favorite Star Wars songs, and then I went for another run.
Unbelievable. I gotta tell you, not making the soccer team was the best thing that ever happened. I could see myself being a runner for the rest of my high school career.
You really could. Us cross-country guys
are
just a little different. Come
on. Exactly. Hey, gentlemen, Laura's in. Laura, good morning. It's good to see you, too.
Good morning, Mr. Mack. Good
great to have you here. Oh, good. Carly's in, too. Okay, we got 4 out of 9. That's great. Good morning, Carly.
What's that noise in the background on your screen, Carly?
Oh, I'm sorry. Melanie is just awake, and she's making a lot of noise, so I apologize in advance for any noise. I kind of have to watch her a little bit, because my mom's on Zoom, and so
Got it, Carly. No problem. Just remember the protocol. We've got to mute our mics unless I call on you, okay?
Yeah, and Carly.
Thank you.
Since it's first period of the day, I think that we need to save a pledge.
Carly, that's a great idea.
Hey, and Carly, just a quick thought, if you're looking to have Melanie do something, I just did this incredible remote experience with Disney. It's like you're actually in Disney World.
All right, Chris, please mute. Okay. Ricky's in. Ricky, good morning. How are you? Hey, Ricky, no protocol, no headphones on during Zoom. Come on, let's take those off, please. Thank you. All right, so we have Zoe?
Oh, it's Zoe.
Yeah, actually, I don't think so, but it's okay. All right, Zoe, good to have you in. So,
Bethany, yo, this hokey's amazing, yo.
So, what did I just say? You gotta mute your mic, okay? Right. Sorry, Bethany.
Oh, so sorry.
Thank you. Bethany, it's so good to see you, man. Hi. Yeah, just remember hoodies, you know, it was still, yeah, you shouldn't really have the hood up right now. Thank you so much. Okay. Yes, let's do that pledge right now. Thank you, Carly.
I pledge
allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the
the attendance. This is unacceptable. Do you know how embarrassing this is? You're my son and you're late. Good to see everybody again. Thank you so much. Okay. All right. So today, oh, we have one more coming in, and it's Diffie? Who's Diffie? Wait a minute here. The protocol is you're supposed to have a name that's identifiable.
Yo, Mr. Mack.
Okay, what is it, Joe?
That's Judas Balling name.
Judah, that has to be fixed for tomorrow. It shouldn't be Diffy, it should be Judah. So Judah, good morning. Judah, are you there? Let's get to page 265. Remember where we left off in the last session. We are still working at the end of the Middle Ages. This is the time where we have the revival of trade, and that's leading to the modern period of history. I want to give you a prompt for you to work on for the next about 1 minute, and that prompt is, why did the revival of trade lead to the revival of towns and cities?
What page are we on?
Okay, we're on page 265. Bethany. It's page 265. And Bethany, do you have paper? Peter, you may go to the bathroom, yes. So while Peter's going to the bathroom, Judah, I want you to tell us, what is the answer? What do you have based on that prompt of why trade brought the revival of towns and cities? Judah, I'm waiting. Judah? Are you there? All right.
Yo, Mr. Mack, I'm not gonna lie. I didn't know there were sports trades back in the Middle Ages.
All right, so thanks so much. Oh, yes, Laura.
Isn't this about globalization?
You know, Laura, that is exactly right. Excellent answer. Well done. Peter.
Yes, Mr. Mack, isn't it about the growth of cities and towns that develop and add to the modernization of the world all over the Middle Ages?
Now, Peter, I couldn't have said it better. That is the exact answer. So, listen, guys, I want to cut off early today. I think you've done a great job in all that we've done. So I want you to look at the Google Classroom and just see for once in the, you know, we never hardly do this right, no homework.
No homework? Let's go!
All right, guys, have a great day.
Thank you,
Mr. Mayor. See you next session. Judah, I knew it.